Okay, in this video, we are going to take the definition that lnx is equal to the integral from 1 to x of 1 over t, dt, and we'll prove some log properties based on this definition. So here we go. But first of all, let me just show you guys what the derivative of natural log of x is first. And keep in mind, we are using this right here for the definition. So to differentiate natural log of x, we will just put this right here. And as we can see, we just have to differentiate the integral going from 1 to x of 1 over t dt. And this is so nice because we can use the first fundamental theorem of calculus. All we have to do is to put the x right here because it pretty much says derivative and integral pretty much cancel out. So we just have 1 over x like that. And the derivative of x is just 1, so 程度 doesn't really matter. This right here is it. Don't put down the plus c because this right here is just the derivative, right? And now let's take a look at the properties. Perhaps the first one to show you is this. What if we have natural log of x to the r's power? As we know from our algebra class, we can take the r to the front, but don't minus 1 because we're not doing the derivative yet. But this right here should be equal to r times ln of x, right? How can we do this though? Well, we will actually do it by taking the derivative of this function, and you'll see how we are going to do it. Here we go. Of course, you can first put the x to the r's power right here, but I have already shown you that natural log of x has a derivative of 1 of x right here, right? So here is the deal. Let's make some observation, right? Observation. Today, if you have to differentiate, let's say, I just want to differentiate natural log of x to the r's power. Because we have this already, so what we can do first is, well, put the inside in the denominator. So we have 1 over x to the r's power. And then by the 程度, we have to multiply by the derivative of the inside. And as we all know, the derivative of x to the r's power is equal to rx to the r minus 1 power. Here you do minus the 1, right, for the power. And that's pretty much it. And now we just have to simplify this a little bit. As you can see, though, this is like saying x to the r times x to the negative 1. And we can just cancel out the x to the r. And that's very nice. On the top, we will have r over on the bottom. This is x to the negative 1. Put it on the bottom. It's just x, like this. That is very nice. So this is our first observation. And the second observation is that if today we are going to just differentiate r times natural log of x, well, we can use the properties of derivative. A constant multiple, you can just take that to the front. So this is the same as saying r, and you multiply by the derivative of natural log of x. And because we have seen that this right here is just 1 over x, all in all, we just get r times 1 of x. Of course, that's the same as r over x. Now, here is the deal. Notice this and that have the same derivatives. So that means this and that, they are not necessarily equal yet. We just know they are, you know, off by a constant. So now we can say ln of x to the r, it's equal to r times ln of x. But we don't know if it's off by what constant. So I will just put down plus c. So that's pretty much what we have. How can we figure this out though? Don't worry. Just plug in some number for x and we'll see what that c is. Okay? Before we do that, we will have to figure out a value of natural log that we actually know. So let me actually do this one right here, number 3. Let's figure out what natural log of 1 is because I would like to use 1 right here. Right, so let's do that one first. Okay, to figure out natural log of 1, using this for the definition, we will just have to compute the integral from 1 to 1, and we have 1 over t here and then dt. And this is so nice because the integral from 1 to 1, this right here is nicely equal to 0. So that's very, very nice. So now we can come back here, and we'll just say let x equal to 1, pick an easy value, and just go ahead and plug that in. So we get the left-hand side, natural log of x, which is 1 now, and then to the r's power. And this is equal to r times natural log of 1. And this right here, we have t plus c. Well, 1 to the r's power is just 1, so here we have ln of 1. And this right here is r ln of 1, of course, plus c. Now, do we know what ln of 1 is? We do, 0. Likewise, this will be 0. So as you can see, this is 0, is equal to r times 0, just 0, plus c. So of course, we can say that c is equal to 0. Therefore, we do have the nice property that this is indeed equal to that, because c is equal to 0 anyway. This right here is equal to r times natural log of x. Very good. And that's the second property. And in fact, we have the third one right here as well. Very good, right? Okay, now, let's see, what if we have the famous ones? Okay, what if we have two things multiplying instead of natural log? And let me just call them to be x and y. What's natural log of x times y? As we all know from our algebra class, this right here is equal to ln x plus ln y. But we'll prove it this time. Using this for the definition though. So here we go. Put x times y in here. So we have the integral from 1 to x, y, and we have 1 over t dt like this. How can we handle this next though? This is the integral going from 1 to x, y. The deal is that we are going to make a cut somewhere. And a nice cut is we will just go from 1 to x first. And we have the 1 over t dt. This is so nice because this is exactly ln of x. But don't forget the other piece. We have to pick it up from where we left off, which is going from x, and we have to finish it. So this is xy, and we still have the 1 over t dt right here. So that's pretty much the idea. This is good. It's just ln of x. This right here. We don't know if it's ln of something yet, because we don't have this in that form. It's okay. Just do some substitution. This is how we are going to do it. Let t equal to something. Ideally, we want to see a 1 for the limit of integration, right? 1 somewhere. Okay, this right here is t goes from x to t is equal to xy. Well, I want to have 1 somewhere, so I want to have the x. And let me use another variable. Let me just say u like that. This is actually very nice. Okay, look at this. Keep in mind, t and u are our variables. X is just like a number, right? So when we differentiate both sides, we get dt equals x times du. That's very nice. And we'll take this from the t world to the u world. Check this out. When t goes from x to xy. Let's see. This right here will give us the integral in terms of u. When t is equal to x, put it here, we have x being equal to x times u. That means u has to be what? That means u has to be 1. So u has to go from 1. Very nice. And if t goes to x times y, we put it here. That has to be xu. And u will have to be what? U will have to be y, isn't it? Yes, so u will have to go to y like that. Very nice. And now check this out. We have 1 over t, and t is xu. So here we have 1 over xu. Dt is x du. This is so nice because the x and x cancel each other out very nicely. And now let's just put this down as well. We have the integral going from 1 to x. And we have 1 over t dt. And we add this with that one. As you can see, this right here is nicely equal to ln of x. Very nice. And for the second one, as you can see, we go from 1 to y, 1 over u du. And keep in mind, u is just a dummy variable. You can use like p, whatever letter that you want right here, as long as you have the integral going from 1 to x of 1 over whatever, and this is d the same whatever, you get natural log of x. But in this case, we have the u. So for the blue portion, we have ln of y. Very, very nice. And of course, we do have the plus in between. So this is the property that we know. Ln of xy is equal to ln of x plus ln of y. Very, very interesting, huh? Now, of course, we have the other one. What if we have x over y? So let's do that quickly. Number 5, ln of x over y. And you guys can pause the video and try to think about this first. But it's pretty much the same step. It's just a substitution part is slightly tricky. Anyway, we are going to integrate this from 1 to x over y. And we will have to have the 1 over t dt. And just like what we did over here, we will have to break it apart. The first one is the integral going from 1 to x. And we have the 1 over t dt. I know you want to put on subtraction. But no, we cannot yet. This is the integral going from 1 to x. We have to pick it up by putting down plus. And the integral going from x to x over y. Right? That's the integral property. Right? And then we have the 1 over t dt. So this is what we will have to deal with. This is done. This is not yet. Again, do a substitution. So let's do that right here. Let t equal to something. Well, if you let t equal to xu, sure, it will work, but you have to do it another substitution. So I will leave that to you. I am going to let t equal to x over y times u. You'll see why. First of all, x and y, they are just numbers. So if I differentiate both sides, this right here will still give me x over y, and we will have the du right here. And now, take a look right here. Here we have the integral going from x t is equal to x to t is equal to x over t, y, right? Now, in the u world, when t is equal to x, we will have to put the x right here. So we have x being equal to x over y times u. So in that case, u will have to be what? U has to be equal to y so that they cancel, then you get x over x. X is equal to x. So you get u equals y, right? When t is equal to x, u will be equal to y. And when t is equal to x over y, let me just put that right here, x over y. That's equal to x over y times u, so u will have to be 1. Very good, u is equal to 1. Very interesting, huh? And again, we'll just do the usual business. This is 1 over t, which is that. Let me just keep it as how it is. X over y times u, and dt is that, which is x over y du. They cancel each other out very nicely. That is very good. And now, of course, we still have this right here, namely the integral going from 1 to x, 1 over t dt plus this integral in blue. Something is right, something is wrong. I don't know. This right here is actually totally right because we're actually going to switch the limit of integration. And to do that, we just have to make the plus negative. That's all. So in fact, this right here is the integral going from 1 to x. And we have 1 over t dt. But I'm just going to make that negative so that I can legitimately switch the limit of integration. And we will just go from 1 to y. And here we have the 1 over u du. And as you can see, for the first one, this right here is nicely equal to natural log of x minus. For the second one, we have what? This right here is pretty much the same as that. It's going to be natural log of y. That's it, natural log of y. So another property that we used to know, and we proved it with integral. Anyway, as always, thank you guys so much for watching, and that's it.